Hello all, I welcome you for 1 week faculty development program on e-content development and effective use of ICT. Here we are going to discuss about online delivery of contents, that is conduction of online classes. For this, there are number of applications are available such as Google Meet, Microsoft Teams, WebEx, Zoom. In this video, we will discuss about Google Meet. To start Google Meet, we can click on Google Apps by clicking on these 9 dots and select Meet from here, or we can directly type the URL as meet.google.com and just enter. It will redirect us to the Meet page. Here we can join or start a meeting. Click over there. If we want to join a meeting, we need to enter the meeting code over here. Or if we want to start a new meeting, we can give the name for that meeting. It is getting ready. It will checking the cameras and microphone. Camera is starting. Camera is started. I am just closing it. And here we can mute the microphone also. In some cases, browser may ask for permissions to allow camera and microphone. Just allow those permissions and click over here, join now. This is the discussion room is created by Google Meet. The name for this meeting is Demo 1-2-3, and this is the URL we can share with the participants to join this meeting, or we can invite the people by clicking over here, add people, and enter the email addresses of the participants. In this video, we are going to discuss the features of Google Meet. There are buttons available at the bottom sides. At the bottom side, the first one is for microphone. Shortcut for that is Control D. Second button is for leave call. It will end your session. And this is the button for turning on or off camera. Shortcut for that is Control E. This is the button for turn on captions. If you click over here, whatever you are speaking, the captions are automatically displayed at the bottom side. Here it is the button for present now. If you want to present your screen or something to your participants, you can click over here. There are options: share your entire screen, a window, or a Chrome tab. For demo purpose, I am selecting Chrome tab. Right now, there are two Chrome tabs are available. That is in one Meet is going on, and in second, I have just Google. So I don't want any audio. So I am unchecking this box and just click on share. Now, this tab is shared with the participants. And after the discussion, we can click on stop, and your presentation is off, and again we can come back to the webcam view. Here there are three dots are there. There are more functions are available. Here the first function is record meeting. If your account is of G Suite Enterprise version, then you are able to record the meetings. And if you have that account, and if you click on record meeting, your recordings will be saved into the Google Drive of the host account. Here it is option for change layout, so there is no need to change layout. Auto is better. Next is full screen. Next one is again turn on captions. Next one is settings. In the settings, we can change the settings for audio and video. If you want to change your microphone, you can change from here. Or if you want to change your camera, if you want to change the resolutions, we can change it from here. I am not going to change anything. I am just clicking on done. That's all from here. Next thing is just click on this people button, and here we will able to see how many participants joined this meeting, and we can see their names, or we can directly add people from here again if required. Next tab is given for chat. Here we can tell to the all participants what are the instructions we want to give. This is the public chat. If you type anything, it will be shared with all the participants. In the coming videos, we are going to discuss how to take attendance of participants, how to share widescreen with the participant, how to use raise hand function in the Google Meet, and so on. Thank you.